Before proceeding, please make sure to subscribe and turn on the bell icon for upcoming videos. The calcifying odontogenic cyst, also called calcifying cystic odontogenic tumor, was first described by Gorlin in the year 1962, hence given the name Gorlin cyst. It's an uncommon and benign developmental cyst which arises from odontogenic epithelium and possess the potential for calcification. The cyst is extensively diverse in terms of its clinical presentation, its histopathologic features, and biological behavior. This means that the cyst has so many clinical variants. And up to date, different classification systems and nomenclature for the lesion and its variants has been suggested and has led to controversies among pathologists. In this video, I will not talk about the previous classification systems. Instead, I will talk about the present classification system presented by the WHO in the year 2017. The classification system is based on these three features stated. The lesion has been classified in three categories. Described as calcifying cystic odontogenic tumor, also called calcifying odontogenic cyst, which is the focus of this video. As the name implies, this lesion has more of a cystic characteristic. The second type is dentinogenic ghost cell tumor, which are of solid types and described as true neoplasms. These tumors account for less than 5% of all cases. The third type is ghost cell odontogenic carcinoma. These are extremely rare and arises as a result of malignant transformation of the cyst. The first type, which is the calcifying cystic odontogenic tumor, presents in two ways. In 65% of cases, the cyst presents alone, and in 20% of cases, it presents in association with odontomas. Since we can see here that the majority of cases presents as cystic lesions, either alone or in association with odontomas, therefore the authors prefer to use the simpler designation of calcifying odontogenic cyst. Let's come to some clinical features of the cyst. The cyst appears with equal frequencies in maxilla and mandible, with no sex predilection, and about 65% of cases are found in incisor and canine region of the jaws. The cyst arises either within the bone and intraosseous or within the gingival soft tissue, let's say extraosseous and peripheral. If present within the bone or intraosseous, the cyst causes intrabony painful expansion of the jaws, resulting in facial asymmetry. About 5 to 17% of all cases are extraosseous or within the gingival soft tissues, appearing as localized, sessile or pedunculated gingival masses. Radiographically, the cyst appears as unilocular and well-defined radiolucency, measuring about 2 to 4 cm in diameter. The cyst may even appear multilocular and with a diameter even up to 12 cm. But the cases with a diameter of this extent is extremely rare. In about one-third or one-half of cases, small radio-opaque densities are observed within the cystic cavity. These radio-opaque densities are either irregular or tooth-like in structure. The cyst may also cause resorption or divergence of adjacent roots. In about one-third of all cases, the cysts are associated with an unerupted tooth, which is mostly a canine. In a histopathologic section, the cyst possesses three parts: a cystic lumen, an epithelial component, and a connective tissue component, or the fibrous capsule. The epithelial lining of the cyst is about 4 to 10 cellular thick. The basal cells of the epithelium are cuboidal or columnar in shape and resembles ameloblasts or enamel-forming cells. Above this basal layer lies the layer of loosely arranged and star-shaped epithelium, resembling the stellate reticulum cells of the tooth germ at the cap stage of tooth development. Within the epithelial component, a variable number of ghost cells are present. And this is the most important characteristic feature of the cyst. Let's have a closer look of these ghost cells and state few points about them. Well, ghost cells are balloon-shaped, elliptical, and pale eosinophilic cells that have lost their nuclei and have a clear cytoplasm with no cellular organelles. Calcification within these cells are common. The cells are believed to be transformed odontogenic epithelial cells, and the mechanism of this transformation is still unclear and controversial. Some believe that this cellular transformation represents squamous metaplasia, with subsequent calcification caused by ischemia. Others concluded these cells to represent different stages of normal or abnormal keratinization. The ameloblast-like basal cells of the lining epithelium may stimulate the underlying connective tissue cells and by differentiate them into odontoblast-like cells, resulting in the formation of dysplastic dentine or dentinoid, lying just beneath the basal layer. Coming to the treatment, the cyst can be treated with simple surgical enucleation. This treatment has shown higher success rate and fewer recurrences. I hope this video helps. If you think this video was really helpful, please do like the video and subscribe the channel and help me reach more people by sharing the video with friends. Besides, if you have any questions regarding this video, you may write them down in the comment box. Thank you for watching.